What is good, YouTube? It is your boy Q Souls, and I'm back with another video for you guys. Make sure if you haven't done so already, hit that subscribe button below. And if you like today's video, hit that thumbs up. Helps me out a lot, pushes me to new faces, and helps my channel grow. Now for today's video, if you follow my Instagram at QAkery, you know that before I even post a video, I always post the shoes of whatever I get coming into the closet. And one question that I get consistently in my DM is, how do you get so many sneakers? So first of all, I am not rich. I am a struggling college student with 3 minimum wage, actually below minimum wage jobs technically here at the school. So today's video is going to be my top 3 ways with an honorable mention on how to get sneakers for cheap in 2021. I know that's what you guys came here for from the title and the thumbnail, so that's a lot. Let's not waste your time and jump right into the list. Method number 1 on how to get cheap sneakers in 2021 is buy used. I know what you guys are thinking. Used isn't really that cheap, or used shoes, who wants a pair that somebody else already wore, blah, 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 blah. I know nothing beats the feeling of opening a box and you just have the crisp DS pairs. But I'm telling you, as you've seen from my last video, I just got this shoe, an OG colorway 2016 Black Metallics, for only $150, and they are used. But look at the condition. Beautiful. I got them for $150. If you go check StockX, go whatever you want to check, this shoe in a size 7 especially runs for $360+. I don't have that kind of money to be getting the shoe that I want. 100% authentic from the Go app. Buy used is the method to go. I know nothing beats a brand new pair, that brand new shoe smell. Trust me, I get it. I am big on that too. I love a new pair more than the next sneakerhead. But buy used. If you want to get dope sneakers for cheap, used is always the way to go. I'm telling you, try to search, find whatever you can, buy used. That is method number 1 on how to get cheap sneakers. Trust me. Method number 2 on how to get cheap sneakers is, do not settle and put in your time. And what I mean by this is, me personally, you can ask anybody, every single night I spend 3 to 5 hours searching on various sneaker places for shoes. I do not just settle for StockX or GOAT sizes. I know that's the two famous resale companies. That's where everybody get their sneakers based their price, blah, 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 blah. But I never settle. I do not care. If I don't have to pay the prices on StockX or pay the prices on GOAT, I'm not going to. I spend 3 to 5 hours every single night hunting for my pair of shoes. And when I say that, don't just go to StockX or GOAT. You got Poshmark, OfferUp, what we got? You just got to search. I go everywhere. Poshmark, OfferUp, eBay, whatever the case may be, I am hunting for pairs automatically. I'm consistently hunting for a steal. You have to be able to put the work in and actually want to look for shoes in your size and for steals. Now, for me personally, I have an abnormal obsession and love for sneakers, so you may not want to spend 3 to 5 hours every night like me. I don't know why I do it, but it's just something that I do every night, and it's part of my daily routine. I just love looking for sneakers and love finding steals, so I put the time in. If you're not willing to put the time in, then go ahead and pay for GOAT prices, go ahead and pay for StockX prices. Do whatever you want to do. I'm just letting you know, if you look hard enough, I promise you that you can find the same shoe you want for much less than StockX or GOAT prices. Put in the work and do not settle, I'm telling you. And this brings me to step 3, or number 3, whatever, you get what I'm saying. Number 3 on the list, this is actually a quote unquote old school type sneakerhead thing, but it's really huge, and that is, build relationships with people. Everybody knows that sneakers is now a multi-billion dollar industry. So what I mean by this is, everybody is quote unquote the plug. I get that everybody resells sneakers now, but that's not what I mean. Me personally, how I get a lot of cheap sneakers is, if you have been tuning into my channel, I always shout out at InkKid23 on Instagram. I met him through OfferUp. I sold him a pair of shoes, and then our relationship just grew based on that. We literally look out for each other. We wear the same exact size. If I so happen to can't get a shoe, he's not gonna make me pay for a resale. So just for an example, if a shoe is $350 resale, but I couldn't get the shoe and he has it, and let's say he doubled up, he will bless me with a pair. Maybe I'll just throw him a one-on-one sneaker trade, or I will get like $150 to $200 knocked off that. And sometimes I even pay just retail to him. So things like that. Literally build a relationship with other people who absolutely love sneakers, not just people who's looking for the quick buck. So I don't mean just go on pages and be like, oh, I'm friends with this reseller, I know you guys. Most resellers nowadays is just trying to get that profit, which is no problem. I'm not knocking none of you guys. I'm not saying that. Do your thing, resell whatever you want to resell. I'm just saying, if you're trying to get cheap sneakers, you need to find that one person, make a good relationship, an actual genuine relationship that's not just sneakers. Me and my plug, InKid23, his real name is Fabian, and all that good stuff. We don't only talk about shoes all the time. I know his daughter, I've been to his house, we talk about life, he checks up on me, I check up on him, just things like that. Yes, we met through sneakers, but our relationship built more than that. And now whenever I need a sneaker, he knows that I do YouTube, he knows what I'm trying to grow. If I need a shoe, he'll send it my way. If I was unable to get a shoe, he'd be like, hey, you want to do a review on this shoe? Or do you want these? Like, just stuff like that. You guys have to go out there and build a relationship. And the reason I said this is kind of an old school thing is because back then, the sneaker community, when you was doing all those camping out for shoes and stuff like that, that's where you would meet these genuine people that have love for sneakers and genuine people that would look out for people that look out for them. Just things like that. But now it's just all about reselling, making a quick profit. Even your quote-unquote plug that's the friend, he's still gonna make you pay $380 for a shoe. Like, no, that's just not how it should be. I know you're trying to get your profit, I know it's your business, blah, 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 do whatever you want. But for to get cheap sneakers, and how I personally get cheap sneakers, I build relationships. And he's not the only one. I got a good friend in New York too that helps me out a lot, makes me pay way below resale to get a shoe that I miss. And this is the most effective way in my personal opinion. And last, which is my honorable mention, this is not necessarily a method to get quote-unquote cheap sneakers, but it's a method to get sneakers that's way less than the StockX, Go, Flight Club, all those prices. And that is, talk to your local resellers. I know in my last step I was saying that resellers just want the quick buck and all that good stuff, but actually, some of them actually look out for you. And what I mean by that is, so GOAT would have it for $380, and then you get hit with all them other fees. If you go local and shop with somebody that's just starting reselling the sneakers, they'll probably give you that shoe just for $300 flat and ship them to you. So things like that. So this is not a method to get cheap sneakers. This is my honorable mention on how to get sneakers that's way less than StockX and GOAT prices. Go local. You live in Florida, find that Florida reseller that just started off, because the people that are just starting off in the resale business cannot just hold because they don't have all the connections and stuff like that. So they can't pay that super high price because people are going elsewhere because they already go. People are already going to well-established resellers and things like that. So you need to buy local. Most of them sell on OfferUp. I mentioned this earlier. Most of them sell on OfferUp. So check OfferUp. Check your local resellers. You would get the shoe for way less than what it is. I don't do this because I'm just not paying resale, period. I just hate paying resale. I'm just trying to get my shoes and trying to live because I actually love sneakers and actually wear them. But yeah, so for everybody DMing me out there, how I get so many shoes, oh, you must be rich, how you got, I'm not. Like I said, struggling college student, 3 minimum wage jobs, I ain't got it like that. So this is what I do. Those first 3 methods is how I get so many sneakers. 1, I buy used. I do not care. I do love brand new DS sneakers, but if I can get them for way cheaper and they're used and not that bad condition, that's me. Secondly, I put in the time, 3 to 5 hours every night when I'm bored. I can't do nothing here in college anyway in this area, so I just sit down, lay down. I'm on every single app, not just Golden StockX, Poshmark, eBay, Off. I don't care where it comes from. I have authenticators that are friends, and I use the Check app. By the way, code QSOLS will get you 1 free legit check on the Check app. But anyway, yeah, and then the third step, you build relationships with people, genuine relationships, past just resale and past just the love for shoes. And then that honorable mention one, just to get shoes a little bit cheaper than what they are, find your local resellers. They're probably always selling them cheaper. But yeah, anyway, that's how I get the stuff. I really hope this video helped. With that being said, I'm going to end off with a quote. And today's quote is actually by Jay-Z. And it reads, "They are scared to be themselves. They feel like nobody will accept them if they are themselves." And the reason I love this quote by Jay-Z is because it's just true, like how this world is right now, it's just so true that people are so scared to be themselves, and people are so scared to just do what they actually love because of somebody else's satisfaction. They want approval from everybody else. Approve yourself, love yourself, and I promise you your happiness and everything that's supposed to be in your life will be there. And to end it off, you know the quote, you know the motto, aim high, spread love.